Kwanza,
yes.
I think it will be important for you to introduce yourself.
Again. Yes, sure. I am Apostle Satwinda Romi from House of Praise International in Kitengela, married to one husband.
Mm-hmm.
We have beautiful sons and daughters.
Right. Yes.
Beautiful and handsome.
Yes.
And I thank God for saving me from the religion that I was in, from because I'm born and brought up in an Indian family.
Mm-hmm.
I served in the temple, and I thank God so much for salvation.
Wow.
And that now I am in the church worshiping the true God through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I've gone through so much in my life, and the Lord told me, whatever you've gone through and whatever I've delivered you from, I need you to go out there and to speak to the broken and to speak to those who feel like they don't have hope.
Right.
So that's when I became a pastor, and the Lord has been really gracious to me. I've been through tough, I've been through smooth, but through it all, He's never left me.
Amen.
And that is why I'm serving God today, and I'm very excited to know this true God.
Wow.
Yes.
That's powerful.
Yeah.
Today, our theme for February is The Lord is Strong and Mighty.
Yes.
It comes from the book of Psalms chapter 24 verse 6 to 10.
Yes.
But this Sunday we are declaring, and we are declaring that the Lord is strong and mighty over our nation and our leaders.
Yes.
And you have spoken this before. You've said God loves Kenya. God,
yeah.
God loves our leaders. Our leaders are there,
yeah,
for a reason. I mean, and for us it's very important to respect authority because it's been put there by God.
Very true.
So I just wanted you to, you know, you have a passion for this nation.
I do.
Yes.
Because I know God loves Kenya. If you see what we've gone through and we are still strong.
Right.
You know, sometimes Kenya is like Israel. You
mm-hmm.
know, they have fought physical battles. We have fought spiritual battles, as in losing our soldiers. You know, and Kenya has been through thick and thin. Think
true.
About it. Sometimes in the economy sector,
mm-hmm.
sometimes in the tourism sector. But somehow we rise up again because God loves Kenya so much. Think about January, we have rains. As in, I don't think we've had, nobody would have expected that.
Yeah.
But you see, before something happens, God speaks to His servants in Kenya in the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
They rise up in fasting and praying for this nation. Like last year, there were a lot of 21-day fasting and prayers.
Right.
There was a lot of fasting and prayer at the close of 2015. And you see, it's because God loves Kenya and He sees what is ahead. And that is why when we lose soldiers or, you know, politically something happens,
mm-hmm.
we all of a sudden, there's a lot of peace in the whole nation. There are no chaos. If something El Nino, anything happens to us, Kenya is so strong. We are not shattered by what we go through because
sure.
God loves Kenya very much. And that is when I was coming here and I was telling God, I need you to speak a new word for Kenya. And I need you to tell me what I'm telling people today about Kenya. And all I felt in my heart is go and tell them that I love Kenya.
Wow.
It is a country where we have freedom of worship. It is a country where our own president defends the church. It is a country, you know, many nations, we have examples of nations where they say they don't want crosses.
Mm.
They don't want crosses on the churches.
True.
And that was it. No crosses the next day. But in our country, when there was an attack against the church, you see, the president defended us and he said, no, let us not do this to the church. You see, so church is really respected in this nation. Church is really respected. Men of God are really respected in this nation. I mean, you go to State House, and I mean, when there's this Labor Day and things like that, the first thing is before even the president speaks, we are told, let a minister of God come and pray.
Wow.
Before even the president. So there's a lot of respect of God. There's freedom of worship. And there is a lot of fear of God in our country. And that is the reason why God loves Kenya dearly. Many missionaries all over the world have sprung from this nation, Kenya.
True.
Many, 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 many. Many Kenyans have gone outside to other countries and have brought development. I just feel in my spirit that God loves Kenya and Kenya is like the apple of God's eye.
Amen.
Yes.
And so today,
yeah,
we declare that the Lord is strong and mighty for Kenya and
yes.
for our leaders.
And God is going to fight for our nation.
Amen.
He surely will.
That's
that is
right.
what I know in my spirit. God will fight for our nation. You see, God told Abraham, You know, Abraham was telling God, even for 10 people, you know, if Abraham would have continued interceding, people say, probably the nation would have been saved.
True.
Now, in Kenya, we know there are more than 10 who seek God. There are more than 10, you know. So if God was ready to spare a whole Sodom and Gomorrah for 10, 15 people, what about our nation?
True.
You see? So what I can say is that for me in my spirit, I know that God is going to fight for Kenya and he will never leave us nor forsake us. And even this coming election, I want to say and I want to declare there will be peace because we are going to stand in prayer.
Amen.
We are going to stand in prayer and God is going to fight for us. And there are so many things that God, you know, we are in the physical realm, you see. There are so many things that God has stopped in the spiritual that we cannot see.
True.
There are so many battles he's fought for us that we have not seen. You see, this peace that we have, it's because God is fighting for Kenya and God will continue showing his strength for Kenya.
Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. I think we will release you
yeah.
so that you can share the word that God has put in your heart.
Yes.
And from there we will continue. But thank you again for coming through.
Thank you so much. Always a pleasure.
Amen. Yeah. Karibu sana.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Well, once again, it's a blessing to share the word of God with you. And I'd like to thank everyone who watches me on CYM. I have received your messages, your prayer requests, and I want you to know that we are praying for you. It is a pleasure to pray. Personally, I love prayer so much. And today, as the Lord was sending me here, the Lord gave me this scripture in Philippians chapter 4 and verse 6 to share with you. Philippians chapter 4 and verse 6 that says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God." That people are so anxious everywhere. People are so afraid everywhere. And I just want to encourage you to do that. There's nothing God cannot give you in this life. The Bible says in Romans chapter 8 verse 29, if he gave us his only son, along with his son, what else won't God give us? There is nothing that God will not give you. God wants to give you good things. God has good plans. And he has already told us in Jeremiah 29:11. I don't know what challenge you're going through. I don't know what mountain is before you. But I want to tell you that in this limited realm, which is called the physical realm, we are kings and queens who are ruling and reigning in the spiritual realm. And we know that the spiritual has more power than the physical. Why? Because Jesus Christ said, if you have faith, even like a mustard seed, you can tell a whole mountain to be uprooted and to drown itself in the sea and to get into the sea. Why? Jesus Christ was trying to tell us that the spiritual realm is so powerful that whatever happens in the spirit world affects the physical world. And in the spirit world, the Bible says, we are sitting with Jesus Christ in heavenly places. In the spiritual realm, we are sitting with Jesus Christ as adopted sons of God. And so it is good for the believer to know the authority that they have. And let me tell you, I love this scripture in Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 35. Let's just read Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 35. And I'm going to major on this word. Therefore, do not throw away your confidence, which has a great reward. Have confidence in God. There are people who have already said that this is not going to work, this is not possible, I have waited on God, it's not going to happen. If God was going to do it, he would have done it long time ago. But the thing is that we have to have confidence in God. We have to have confidence, just the way we know when it is morning, the sun will come out. When it's at night, the moon will come out. It's going to be dark after this hour. It's going to be morning. We'll know morning because nobody goes to sleep saying, what if tomorrow we don't see the sun? What if tomorrow it's going to be dark? What if tomorrow it's not bright? If we have confidence in the creatures and in the creations that God created, how much more should we have confidence in God? You should always have confidence in God that he wants good things to happen in your life. You should always have confidence in God that he can accomplish that which he has started in your life. You should always have confidence in God that he will bless you. He will bless the work of your hands. Let me tell you something. God is not a liar. And the Bible has said that God is not a liar. But why do we lose our persistence? You know that even though the devil is coming against us to resist, you know that persistence wears out resistance. When you know what you want and you stick to it, there is nothing God cannot do for you. When you know what you want. Paul knew what he wanted. Paul knew that he wanted the gospel to be spread. No matter what kind of afflictions he went through, he had this one. He did not focus on the many times that he was imprisoned. He did not focus on the many troubles and turmoils he went through. He did not focus on them, but he focused on the fact. Imagine he's being stoned almost to death, and then he's, instead of praying, "Oh God," you know, if it was me, probably I would have prayed, "Father, please take away these afflictions. Father, please take away this cup. Father, please take away." But instead, he's been stoned. He's almost dying. And Paul says, "Father God, give me more boldness to preach your gospel." How? Because Paul knew what he wanted in life. He wanted this gospel to be spread to the Gentiles. He wanted the gospel spread so much that God honored his focus. God honored what he was pressing toward. And God made sure that most of the New Testament was written by Paul the Apostle, the books that we read till today. God looks at where is our focus. Where is our focus? Where is our aim? What do we want in life? And let us not focus what we have gone through. Let us look at someone like David. David knew what he wanted. David knew that God wants me to be enthroned as the king of Israel, and that is what is going to happen. So no matter what he went through, he did not focus on those things. But we are losing strength in Christianity. We are losing our faith because we focus so much on the problem that the problems become bigger than God. We focus so much on the problem that we lose our hope. We focus so much on the problem that we lose our faith. If you're going from here and you're going from here to Nakuru, for example, we know it must be about 170 kilometers. Now, if you keep focusing on, "I have a very long journey to cover. I have a very, very long journey to cover." If you keep focusing on that, you will realize the journey will be longer than 170 kilometers. You know, as they all say, that when you're waiting for something, you always feel like time is going slow. You're probably waiting for something, and you're probably waiting for something big, and you've been told, "Sit there, it shall be done in the next 10 minutes. We focus so much on every minute, every second. You focus so much, then 10 minutes look like 30 minutes. That is the power of focus. The Bible says, "Don't worry about anything. I know the heart of God." Coming from a religion whereby we did not know the true God. Coming from a religion where religion was just a duty, just to appease my conscience, I would go to the temple. Just to appease my conscience, I would do the prayers that I would do. Just to appease my conscience. But when I came to Christianity, I came to know the true living God. He did not tell me that now that you're a Christian, you will never go through any difficulty. Or I promise you roses. Or I promise you green pastures. You will never go through any hardship. God did not promise me that. But he promised me one thing. I will always be with you. I'll be the fourth person in the furnace. I will be the Lion of Judah in the pit where they throw you with lions. I will be right there with you, like the angel who strengthened our Lord Jesus before he faced his cross. I will always be there with you. I will always strengthen you. He gave me Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10. And I just want to read that scripture to encourage you today that there is nothing God cannot do for you. But we've just got to pursue it in prayer. Pursue it and don't give God rest. Isaiah chapter 62 and verse 6 says, "Oh, you who are watchmen at the gate, do not give God rest. Keep on praying." God, you know something, my father used to tell me, "You are a go-getter." Because if I say, "Dad, I want this," I'll keep insisting until he gives it to me. And I thank God that if he refused to give me exactly what I want, I would tell him, "Dad, but you have to give me something else. At least give me something so that I feel like what I was pursuing, I get it." And that attitude is what God has helped me to grow with. That when you want God to give you something, continue persisting in prayer. Don't worry about anything. There is a lot. If I had time, I would tell you what worry does. Worry will make God so small in your life. Worry will make the problem so big. Worrying is going to make you so hopeless. And remember, the Bible says, if we are wavering, will God do it? Can God do it? Is God able to do it? Does God want to do it? Is it his will to do it? If we waver about, the Bible says we'll receive no good thing. Do you know why I'm positive about our nation, Kenya? Let me give you one example. If somebody like Elijah, the Bible says, Elijah was just a human being like anyone else. Now, if the country where Elijah was is a country that depends on agriculture as its economic backbone, the backbone of its economy, and the servant of God, Elijah, goes saying, no rain for 3.5 years, that country is doomed. Financially, it's low, famine, you can imagine all those problems. Imagine one man would control the economy of that country only through his prayer, and one prayer that God let it not rain for 3.5 years. One person through his prayers could control the economy of Israel. How much and how many Christians are we in this country? And that is why I have hope when these elections are coming up. I have hope knowing that I, one person, Satvinda, if I just pray to God and say, God, let there be peace during our elections. Let the one who will sit on the throne of Kenya, Lord, let it be the man whom you have anointed. If we just pray, I have nothing should worry us in this life, because we have a God who says, if I can give you Jesus Christ, there is nothing that I cannot give you. I want to encourage you this morning. If you had lost your hope at one point, if you had lost faith at one time, if your problems were too difficult, if the sickness was too great, if the financial situation of your life is horrible, whatever you're going through, I want you to rise up right now and cry to God from your heart. Cry to God from your heart and say, Father, don't let me drown. Remember Peter, when he was sinking in the ocean, what happened? Jesus, he said, Lord, save me. And the Lord was faithful. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. If one person can control the economy of a whole country, what about your life? You can rise up. Stop being put down by those problems. Esther was not put down. She did not cover herself with the blanket of worry and anxiety. But she rose up. She said, I will seek God. If I perish, I perish. But I will seek God, because he alone is able to lift me up from my problems. And God does not ashamed the people who put their trust in him. If you have been doing business and it's doing well, rise up, my sister and my brother. Don't let the devil cover you with worry and anxiety. Lift up your voice and say, Father, I still have hope that you are able to take me to reveal to me a business where I can make good money and support my family. You met Peter when they were trying to catch fish. They had nothing. You took them where there was a lot of fish. Take me where my fish are, in the name of Jesus. If your heart is broken in a relationship or you feel shattered, call upon the name of the Lord and tell him, Father, only you know how broken my heart is. Only you can repair and mend my heart. Mend my heart, my Father. Renew my strength, as you have said in Isaiah chapter 40 and verse 31, and bring the right person in my life, God, the person that you created to be my better half, in the name of Jesus. Keep knocking the doors of heaven. Keep asking. I like what Matthew chapter 7 and verse 7 says. It is so wonderful and so beautiful. This is what it says. Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. Everyone who asks receives. Everyone who seeks finds. And the one who knocks, it will be opened to them. Let me tell you, keep knocking until God opens that door. Give him no rest. The Bible gives us the permission to nag God until he does it. Oh, believer, I want you to know that our God is a loving God. One day when I was telling God, Father, I need to get married. I want to get married, Lord, because I want to get into ministry as a married woman. Lord, you need to help me. And I was crying out to the Lord. And when I kept crying, the Lord asked me, show me how serious you are. And I said, Lord, what do I do? And the Lord told me to go to a fasting and prayer center. Now, I knew I was going for 3 days, but God prolonged it as long as he gave me the grace. When I came out of that prayer mountain, after 1 month, God had given, I had met my husband, and after 6 months we got married, because God told me, show me how bad you want it, show me how serious you are, because God does not want mediocrity. You can't just wake up and say, Father, I need this ABCD, and you just go away. No, show God how serious you are. Show God that you will not give him rest. The Bible says, don't give him rest until he does it. So I just want to finish by saying, do not be anxious about anything, but everything tell it to God in prayer, and God is going to change anxiety. He's going to change anxiety. He will take away the anxiety, and he's going to bring your blessings your way. Please be encouraged. I'm not preaching to you something that I just read in the Bible and I feel like preaching to you. I am preaching to you what I have seen in my own life, that when we give God no rest, he will move on our behalf. So please be encouraged. If you are put down by troubles and problems, arise this Sunday and say, I am not going to be put down anymore. I am rising, and I am rising, and I'm calling upon God until it is done. And when you feel tired, tell God, renew my strength. You know what? Even in hopeless situations, there is hope. God does not look at age. You could be 46, and this is when you're saying, God, will I start my life at 46, at 50, at 65? Abraham got a son when he was 100 years. With God, he can do things in your later life that you couldn't do when you were younger. But don't lose hope. That is the cry of the Spirit of God this morning. Don't lose hope. Arise and let God arise in your situation, and your enemies will be scattered. You could have listened to this and you want to give your life to Jesus Christ, and you're saying, I want to give my life to this Jesus. Pastor, I want this God that you have. Just say, Lord Jesus, forgive me my sins as I forgive those who have wronged me. Come into my life and be the Lord and Savior in my life. From today, I am born again. In Jesus' name, amen. Let the Lord fill you with the Holy Spirit, and the Lord will exalt you. The Lord is going to, as you humble, God is going to exalt you. As you decrease, God is going to increase in your life. Congratulations. You have just received eternal life. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you very much, Pastor. Amen. I think we'll just get to pray together.
Yes.
There are quite a number of prayer requests that have come through.
Yes.
Let me just read some of them. There's Washia Anu says, I thank God for life and for you guys. The scripture says that if God doesn't watch over the city, the watchmen are doing nothing. Pray for peace and security in our country.
Yes.
Then Mima says, I pray for my family during this time. Our father is ill. We can't do anything, but we pray for him. I need your prayers.
Yes.
Then we have OP Flo says, pray for my healing and pray for protection and safety to all the children around the world. Yeah. And our house helps wakue na compassionate hearts.
Yes.
Then there's Eric Bonyi, who says he has desires in his heart. He wants God to fulfill that. Philip Lugadiru says, please pray for my friend's dad who was diagnosed with cancer this week. I believe God will do a miracle.
Mm-hmm.
And we have Patricia Wamboi. We have Barbara Toll. We have Anne Blessing, who says, pray for me to start my business that I have been trusting God for. Karey Miner says, trusting God for healing, and many more coming through. So I think you will just pray together with us. We have someone asking for financial breakthrough, healing our nation. Some have desires in their hearts. They desire that God will meet them.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right, let's believe together. Let's join our faith as we pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you and we want to thank you because you are great God. And all those prayer requests that we have just read and many more, there is nothing that is impossible with you, God. Father, I pray that where healing is needed, may you release the healing power of Jesus Christ. Let the healing virtue of Jesus Christ cancel out cancer in the name of Jesus. Let the healing virtue of Jesus Christ enter in those flesh. Let it overcome every sickness and disease in the mighty name of Jesus. I command healing right now in all those people who are suffering in Jesus' name. Father God, we want to pray for the house helps. The Bible says that the heart of man is in the hand of God. I am praying for compassion, my God. I discourage God in the spiritual realm. I discourage that evil spirit that is attacking them, my Father, to hate children. I am praying that you uproot those evil spirits in the name of Jesus. I am praying for love. Pour love in their hearts, my Father. You are a God of justice. Rescue these innocent children against mighty hands in the name of Jesus. Amen. We are praying, God, that you will give them motherly love. More love, God Almighty, that they can ever contain in their heart. Amen. My Father, may you rescue children who are being battered, children who are being used sexually in the wrong way. Lord, may you please come through for us, God, as we call upon your name.
to rescue these children with your mighty arm and your powerful scepter. Lord, we are praying for the nation of Kenya. We know that you love Kenya, my God, and that is why you stand with us in our hour of need. We are praying for our president, my Father. Let him receive wisdom from above on how to rule this nation, my God. Let him be surrendered into your hands as a clay surrendered to the potter's hand. That, my Father, you will direct his heart to make decisions and to do things that are in favor of the God of heaven. We are praying for our leaders, my Father, that, Lord, they will stand in peace. They will stand in agreement. We are refusing violence. We are refusing even verbal violence in the name of Jesus. My Father, charge this nation of Kenya with love. Charge this nation of Kenya with ambience of love and an ambience of loving one another and caring for one another. Lord, we know that you love Kenya. And Lord, you've been fighting for us. Protect our borders. Yes. Protect our soldiers. Mm. My Father, all those working in the diaspora, protect them with the blood of Jesus Christ. Cover our nation with the blood of Jesus, so that whatever the blood of Jesus overcame stands overcome and defeated in this nation in Jesus' name. Whatever people plan in secret and in darkness against our country, reveal it, oh God, in the housetops, in the name of Jesus. Make the enemy weak. Make the hands of the enemy weak in the land of Kenya, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are praying even for those who are suffering financially. The Bible says you give the power to make wealth. Release an anointing of wealth over our land, oh God, and lift up those who are starting up businesses. Lift up those whose businesses are falling down. My God, we are praying for healing in our financial situation, in the name of Jesus. God, may you please look to Kenya. Look to Kenya with favor, oh God. Look to Kenya with favor, my God. Look at Kenya with favor, my God. Release healing. Release everything that we need according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus. We pray for men and women of God to have a burden to fast and to pray for this nation like never before, that your glory may be visible and evidenced in this nation. Father, we love you and we bless you for this platform, God. For those who humble before you will be exalted. May this platform be exalted in this nation, Lord, because they have humbled before you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen and amen. Thank you very much again.
Thank
you. Our regards to church and family. Mm-hmm. And we hope to see you again soon.
At the time of God.
Asante sana. That was Apostle Satvinder Romney. And right about now we go right to DJ Sadiq the Mix Genius on Jikoni. It's a segment where we play new music. Then after that, our psalmist is already here. We'll be having Lois Kim. We chat together. We talk about music and what God is doing in her life. So don't go away.